Namaste everyone and welcome back to Live Stronger. Today we are going to work on our leg muscles, and to start off straight away with our dynamic stretching, 5 repetitions on each side. I'm going to speed up the video a little bit so that I don't take much of your time in showing the same exercise every day. But yes, we need to do the 5 repetitions to ensure our body is unlocked. We get a great mobility for our exercises. So please do the 5 repetitions on each side. It hardly takes a minute or two to do this particular drill. Now, today I have also included 2 new, not new in the sense of their existence, but new in my program, mobility drills, to ensure I get a little bit of more range and stability during my exercises. The first one is alternative hand and leg extension while being on all your fours. So basically, you get in the position like I did right now, just like you're about to do a cat and cow pose, and then you take your arm and your leg into extension alternatively. What does this do? This strengthens and stabilizes our lower back, which helps you in terms of getting a lot of stability, core stability, when you're doing any kind of RDLs or squats, lunges. It helps a lot. It also ensures to strengthen your lower back to an extent wherein it might also give you relief from lower back pain if strength was the reason of you experiencing lower back pain. So this is something which is quite helpful, so please do try. Ensure that you squeeze your glutes when doing the leg extension, and when you're taking your arm up, try to balance as much as possible. Take it slow. If you're unable to balance, just try doing the leg extensions alone and then slowly start adding the arm. Doing it alternate helps you maintain the balance. Don't do the same side at a time. 5 repetitions on each side. Now we move on to our regular deep squat stretch. So you stand straight, take your shoulder width stance, then you start pushing your glutes behind to hinge forward, and as you start feeling your hamstrings at their absolute stretch, slowly start bending your knees to go into a deep squat. And as you go into a deep squat here, for some people your butt cheeks might absolutely touch the floor, for some people it might not. Don't worry, it's just a difference anatomically, but it's good either way if you're able to go into a complete deep squat. Once in your deep squat, just shift the weight onto your ankles one at a time, couple of times, hold there for a few seconds, and we are done with our stretches. Now for my second drill, what I have done is I have put a resistance band around my ankles and then I started doing deep squats. Now the progression of this would be holding a weight, but I just wanted to see if any of my glutes are not firing properly, because lately I was started to feel a little bit of discomfort in my lower back, so just wanted to make sure that I am good with my stability and mobility drills. So I have done about 10 to 12 repetitions of that particular drill, and as you can see, for my warm up I started with an empty bar RDLs. Now I have done 2 sets, 15 repetitions of this particular exercise with 30 seconds break in between. Again, I have mentioned this in my previous videos also, the cue is pretty simple. You need to push your glutes as far behind as possible, as if you're trying to push a wall or a car door or a plate against the wall, while trying to push your arms behind your body's midline. So I'm trying to drive my arms behind me, but that is not possible because there's a bar in between which I'm holding. So the bar is constantly being pushed into my body, into my legs, into my shins as I go down, as my glutes are moving back and I'm hinging forward. What does this do? This keeps my back absolutely tight, doesn't let the load shift onto my lower back. So the cue is pretty simple. I have not yet strapped up because it's an empty bar. So make sure you use the empty bar to warm up, to understand the movement better. And also hold few seconds at the lowermost point couple of times, or maybe every repetition for 2 or 3 seconds, to feel that stretch, to experience stretch. If the stretch is not happening, try to change your stance, try to focus on keeping your back tighter, because if the stretch is not happening, that means the load is shifting, might be shifting a little bit onto your lower back. Now, as I do it with the weight, I'm using the straps, and in this side view, you can see how my glutes move. The other thing which I do when I'm doing it with weight is, as I'm getting up straight, I don't focus on bringing the weight up. What I focus is squeezing my glutes forward. So my force exertion is pushing forward, not pushing up. So as I go to the lowest point, and as I want to stand straight, I squeeze my glutes forward. This pushes my body into a straight line, and automatically the weight raises up because I'm holding the weight. Otherwise, I'm not actually pulling the weight up. I'm actually squeezing my glutes forward. Great exercise for your glutes. In this angle, you can see clearly how I push my glutes back and how I keep my back tight by pushing my arms behind and constantly keeping the bar in contact with my body. If you keep your back, upper back tight, you would not experience any kind of discomfort in your lower back because the weight would always be on your glutes and on your hamstrings. Go as low as possible for you. If you feel a great stretch just below the knees, just stop there and come back up. And coming back up is not just simply lifting the weight. Coming back up is squeezing your glutes forward and thrusting forward. So again, great hamstring and glute exercise. Really strengthens the bit. And we are done with this exercise. For my next exercise, I chose to do leg extensions, but one leg at a time. So the first two sets, I was just trying to figure out how to do it, how to position my legs properly. By third and fourth set, I have figured out that. Now I have done about 12 to 15 repetitions of each leg. I started losing count in between when I wasn't feeling a bit challenged. I was going a little bit higher on my repetitions, but the weight I kept the same. I was able to push a good amount of weight. So again, four sets, 10 to 12 repetitions. You need to take just about 30 seconds break in between because you're doing one leg at a time. So as one leg is working, the other leg is actually resting. Might not be much of a time, but that 45 second break is more than sufficient. You can also intensify this particular exercise by finishing off like I did in my third and fourth set after doing single leg extensions. After finishing your reps, 10 to 12 repetitions on each side, you can start doing another 10 repetitions with both your legs to get that extra bit of stress in your quad muscles. In my fourth set, you can see I was doing alternative leg because I was tired. So I did not want to stress one leg at a time. So I was doing it an alternative leg extension method. Again, just creating a little bit of variety in a same exercise, which we always do. Just create a little bit of more challenge in it. And as you can see, once I'm done, I'm using both my legs with the same weight to push through for those another 10 repetitions. Get more out of it. Yes, my face really tells how painful that was. And for my next exercise, I'm going to do the donkey calf raises. My favorite in getting a good calf pump. Make sure your toes are at an elevated level, enough elevated level, and your heels drop as down as possible. As you can see in this side view, how I keep pushing up, how my calves are reacting to that particular motion. What I have done is, after I have completed as many repetitions as possible by me, I have held the lowest point of this calf raise for 5 to 10 seconds, that is basically heels down, and created that stretch in my calf muscle to get a little bit more blood pumping in there, as you can see how I'm holding it for 5 seconds. Now for my last exercise, I am going to do the oblique rotations again, 20 to 25 repetitions on each side. Pretty simple exercise. Take a light stick, put it on your back, and start rotating. I've just sped up the video a little bit because it's pretty easy exercise, nothing much to do. Make sure your feet stay grounded. Don't let your feet move. Try to keep your hips as much as straight possible. They will rotate, but try to keep your feet grounded and get the rotations. try to rotate as much far behind as possible, and also try to focus on your obliques working really hard in terms of getting the rotations. And that's it for today. Thank you so much for joining me. I would really appreciate a like. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, do subscribe. I'll be constantly putting out my everyday workouts, my transformation journey. And if you have any kind of feedback or comment or anything which you would like to share with me, please do drop a comment. I would respond to that. I'm finishing off with my static stretches, with my quad hold and with my hamstring stretch, 20 second holds. Pretty simple. We have been doing this on a regular basis. For quad, hold your leg, get in a straight line and start pushing your feet into your butt cheeks. As straight as you stand, you are the better the quad stretch you get. For hamstrings, just place your feet on an elevated space like I'm doing here on an inclined bench, and then push your glutes as far behind as possible. That would create a stretch in your hamstring. Pulling your toes towards your shin exaggerates the stretch. Pretty simple stretch. If you're doing like me on a bench, it might take a little bit to balance, but otherwise the height is as per your comfort. And yes, that's it. This is the last bit of our day workout. A pretty simple, short and easy but intense leg workout. And I was really happy with the kind of pump I was feeling at the end of the workout. So thank you again for joining me. I will see you in the next video where we will be working on our arms. So thank you. Have a good day.